up, wake up, sleepyhead. Roll out of bed, make sure you're fed, cause it's time for Camp UpStreet.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if you're red, pink, or blue. No imposters here, just come as you, cause we're all friends.
Yeah.
At Camp UpStreet.
Woo.
Well, last summer it sure didn't go as planned, so we'll double the fun and warm up the band, cause it's time for
Camp UpStreet!
Yeah! Come on! Here we go!
Let me tell you. It's cabin calls and upstreet halls, water fights and bugle calls, golden squirrels and s'mores contests, toilet towers, yeah, who's the best?
It's small group leaders and hot dog eaters and golden acorns and best friend leaders. Learn and grow more than you know. Learn how to follow and his love will show.
It's gonna be fun!
Yeah, it is!
Don't miss a ton!
Campers! Welcome back to another week at Camp UpStreet! I'm Caleb from That Girl, that Show with That Guy. You already know! And guys, you get to hang out with me all summer as I walk you through the best parts about camp life. Are you still on the fence about this? You definitely won't be after I introduce you to the Giant Swing! No, this ain't no ordinary swing. We don't do things like that here at camp. This swing flies at about 300 miles per hour at 30,000 feet. No, I'm just kidding. But it is as high as I can jump. No, I'm just kidding. I honestly don't know how high this thing is, but it's really high. And it's definitely something you should do while you're at camp. And we're gonna do it right now. Let's go. Did you guys see that? Did you hear me scream too? Actually, don't tell your friends about that. Okay, let's keep my rep fresh here. Okay, look out for me. Thank you. But what you shouldn't do at camp is ride the giant swing blindfolded. It's super easy when you know when the cord's gonna get pulled. But when you don't know, that's a little bit more difficult. So we're just gonna try it out. UpStreet family, say hi to my buddy, Tyler.
Hey.
So I'm not feeling too good right now. The blindfold feels stuck. I don't even know if y'all can see me. Tyler, can they see me?
They can see you.
They can see me. Can they see you?
They can see me.
Good. Okay, so we have stopped now. I have no idea when Tyler's gonna pull this thing. I am shaking for dear life. I might even pee my pants a little bit. I already. I'm still a little shaky from that. I put my body through the ringer for you guys to show you the shoulds and shouldn'ts, I don't even know if those are words, of camp. So definitely should ride the giant swing. Just don't do it blindfolded. Guys, thank you for joining me this week. As always, stay saucy, love on somebody, and I'll see you next week at Camp UpStreet with That Show with That Guy. Peace!
Jesus said, "Come, follow me." Matthew 4:19.
Hey guys, all summer long, we're learning how to follow Jesus, to be kind, and to treat others like he did. Now, I have a question for you. Have you ever been punished when you've done something wrong? Yeah, me too. We don't always make the wise choice, right? Maybe you got called out by a teacher, or your mom got on to you for doing something you weren't supposed to be doing. It is embarrassing, right? When this happens, it feels like people are pointing their fingers at you and saying, "Aha!" Well, today, I want to tell you about a woman who felt just like that. So, let me tell you what happened that day. So, this woman was caught breaking the law. Okay, everyone, point at your screen and say, "Aha!" Awesome. Now this woman, she felt all alone, She was embarrassed. And here's the really bad thing. Back then, the law said that her punishment wasn't just to be embarrassed. Back then, when you broke the law, people didn't just point and say, aha. No, they actually took it one step way further. The law said that this whole group of people were going to throw rocks at her. Horrible, right? So one day, Jesus was teaching outside of the temple. A temple is kind of like a church. And this crowd brought this woman straight to Jesus. The people who were all about keeping the law wanted to see what Jesus would do. Would Jesus point his finger and say, aha? Would he yell? Would he pick up a stone? Okay, but then something crazy happened. Instead of pointing his finger and saying, aha, Jesus looked around the crowd and said, let any of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her. It was like Jesus was saying, if you have never done anything wrong, go ahead, throw a stone. Okay, everyone, point at your screen with your finger one more time, like you're pointing at the woman, and hold it there for me. Got it? Okay, now, if you have ever cheated or bent the rules to win a game, put your hand down. Okay, or if you have ever lied, if you've ever lied, put your hand down. Okay, or if you have ever disobeyed, put your hand down. What? Really? Come on, some of you still have your hand up? You've never done anything wrong in your whole life? Come on, guys, none of us should have our hands up because we all mess up. And the same thing happened in the crowd that day. One by one, everyone put their rock down and walked away until there were only two people left, Jesus and the woman. And Jesus looked at her and he said, go ahead and leave your life of sin. That's right, Jesus forgave her. Jesus cared more about her than he did about the rules or anything else. Jesus didn't want the woman to do wrong things, which is why he told her to stop. More than anything, Jesus wanted the woman to know that she was forgiven. Okay, so imagine yourself back at the position we talked about at the beginning. You've been caught doing something wrong and it doesn't feel good. Maybe you're even embarrassed. You know what Jesus says to you? You are forgiven. Doesn't that feel so good? Isn't it awesome to know that no matter what you do, how you mess up, Jesus will always forgive you? Now, maybe you're thinking, but what about the rules? Shouldn't we still follow those? Or can we break them whenever we want just because we know we're gonna be forgiven? No, because when you break a rule, there are always consequences. But you never have to worry about Jesus not loving you or being disappointed in you. Jesus loves you no matter what. And when you mess up, he offers forgiveness always. And since Jesus always forgives, we should forgive too. That's what it looks like to follow Jesus and forgive everyone. Wait a second. Even the kid that's super mean to you? Yep. We should still follow Jesus and forgive everyone. Even when our brother hits us accidentally and it really hurts? Yep. Remember, when you mess up, Jesus always forgives you. So if we want to follow Jesus, we need to forgive like he forgives us. Even if it's really hard, we should still follow Jesus and forgive everyone. But I know that that's not easy, so let's ask God to help us. God, thank you so much for sending Jesus to show us what it looks like to forgive. Help us to forgive others because you have forgiven us. We love you. Amen.
And how it shows, God, you gave your own. like your love, like your love, love. Like it's so amazing, so we're praising with our hands up. Hands up, hands up. Yeah, there's nothing like your love, like your love, love.
Love all my friends, love everybody like Jesus did.